فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Who took that opinion as well? The great Mu'tazili Imam Abu Ali al-Jubba'i. Abu Ali al-Jubba'i was who? He was the father, stepfather of Abu al-Hassan al-Ash'ari. Abu al-Hassan al-Ash'ari's mother was married to Abu Ali al-Jubba'i, right? That's the man who Abu al-Hassan al-Ash'ari used to debate. He used to debate Abu Ali al-Jubba'i, used to debate him a lot. Abu al-Hassan al-Ash'ari. Because Abu al-Hassan al-Ash'ari, he was what? Abu al-Hassan al-Ash'ari was al-Mu'tazili at the beginning. He went through three levels, Abu al-Hassan al-Ash'ari. The first one was that he was a Mu'tazili. And when he was a Mu'tazili, his mother, and he used to debate with his stepfather. Huh? Abu Ali al-Jubba'i. One day he felt like his stepfather wasn't making sense to him. So he left it. Are you with me? And then he took the opinion of the Karramiyyah. Sorry, Kullabiyyah. He took the opinion of the Kullabiyyah, which is what Ash'ariyyah is today. Are you there? It's just that Ash'ariyyah became much more famous than it. And there are little difference here and there, but the asal is that they're the same. They took that opinion. He took the madhab of his Sheikh Kullabi and he took it on board. Are we all together? And then the third stage Abu al-Hassan al-Ash'ari went through is that he came back to madhab Ahli Sunnah. Sah? He wrote his kitab Al-Ibana. He wrote his kitab Maqalatul Islamiyin. And he wrote his kitab Risalati ila Ahli Thar. Are you with me, brothers? But he came back. But when he came back, of course, he still has some mistakes still with him that he hasn't fully left. Are you there? But jumlatan, generally speaking, he repented and he said, I am upon the madhab and the belief of Imam Ahmad. Ah, he got tired. So the Asha'ira today, when they are called Ash'aris, they are the marhalatul wusta. They're in the middle stage. Not when he was a Mu'tazili and not when he came back to madhab Ahli Sunnah. They are the middle stage. Does that make sense? And Ibn Kathir is the one who mentions this, rahimahullah. He mentions that he went through these three stages. They don't want to take that. They want to believe it. Anyways, Abu Ali al-Jubba'i al-Mu'tazili, he believed that the hadith to be sahih, it has to be aziz minimum. Ah. And also this is also a accusation put against, or is accused of, al-Hakim al-Naysaburi, as I mentioned. But if you look at Hakim's statement is as follows. He says in his kitab Ma'rifat Ulum al-Hadith, he says, وَصِفَةُ الْحَدِيثِ الصَّحِيحِ. The description of an authentic hadith is أَنْ يَرْوِيهَ عَنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ, that it's narrated from the Prophet, صَحَابِيٌّ زَائِلٌ عَنْهُ اسْمُ الْجَهَالَةِ, a companion who is not unknown, it is to be known. وَأَنْ يَرْوِي عَنْهُ تَابِعِيَانِ عَدْلَانِ, and two reliable tabi'is narrated from that companion. ثم يتداوله أهل الحديث بالقبول إلى وقتنا هذا كالشهادة على الشهادة. And he says, then the people of hadith, they use this hadith amongst themselves with acceptance until today. So this to him is what a characteristic. ولذلك that's what Amir Sanani says, وقد رمي من قال بالتوهم. And the person who says this is accused of having wahm. He's done waham, meaning he's deluded, he's wrong in his belief. Some scholars, they said, Hakim didn't mean that this is a description of hadith which is generally authentic. He's only talking about the hadith which is in Sahih Bukhari. He's saying that Bukhari, the hadith that he sees to be sahih are only what is aziz. And that statement like clearly is transmitted from Abu Bakr ibn al-Arabi. Ibn al-Arabi, the great Maliki scholar, he clearly stated that the condition of al-Imam al-Bukhari is that the hadith has to be aziz. Ah, it has to be. And that's where he been refuted on that. وَتُعُقِّبَ فِي ذَلِكَ. He got corrected on that particular matter, and that is, you know, the beginning of Sahih al-Bukhari, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ is a hadith which is غريب. It's It's a hadith which is gharib. Meaning it's a hadith that starts with the one narration. The only companion who transmitted it from the Prophet is who? Umar. And the only tabi'i who narrated from Umar is who? Alqamah ibn Waqas al-Laythi. And the only person who narrated from Alqamah ibn Waqas al-Laythi is who? Muhammad ibn Ibrahim al-Taymi. And the only person who narrated from Muhammad Ibrahim al-Taymi is Yahya ibn Sa'id. And then from there it spread. Are you there? Are we all together? Then it became 200 people, Ibn Rajab mentions. Abdullah al-Mubarak, Sufyan al-Thawri, al-Awza'i, and others narrated it. The last book, the last hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari is what? Kalimatani, khafifatani ala al-lisani, thaqilatani fil mizani, habibatani ila al-rahmani, subhanallah wa bihamdi, subhanallah. Are we all together? This is the last hadith. What is it? It's also gharib. It's gharib as well. So the first hadith Sahih al-Bukhari is gharib. 1111 narration. And the last hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari is what? It's also gharib, 111 narration. So this is the clear evidence that Bukhari is sahih, the condition of two is not, the conditioning of Aziz and Sayyidina Aziz is what Bukhari is. Aziz is what Bukhari's minimum ahadiths are, or the condition of Bukhari is that at least it's Aziz. That's غير صحيح, it's incorrect. Yeah? Does that make sense, brothers? Before we move on, inshallah ta'ala, to the gharib, which is the fourth point that the Shaykh mentions, rahimahullah, and it's the second for us, sorry, it's the third for us when it comes to ahad. There's two points I want to bring to your attention. Tanbihani. I want to bring two things to your attentions. The first one is, Hafiz ibn Hajar, rahimahullah, when it came to the intent of Hakim and Naysaburi, what did we just say? Al-Imam Hakim, the description that he gave to Hadith al-Sahih, right, is that it's what? It's Aziz. That's what he, Hakim and Naysaburi in condition. Hafiz ibn Hajar, not in this kitab, not in the Nusrat al-Nadar, okay, which is a sharh of the Nukhbatul-Fikr, he has another kitab called An-Nukhatu ala ibn al-Salah. And you know he didn't finish Ibn Hajar, the Nukhat. He died, or but he stopped at the Maqlub. Ibn Hajar didn't carry the Nukhat ala ibn al-Salah. Ibn Hajar stopped at the Maqlub. And we'll speak about what Maqlub is. But he said something very powerful of what Hakim al-Naysaburi meant by as-Sahih has to be Aziz. He says, Hafiz says, it means to him, Ibn Salah, Hakim, it means to Hakim, أن يكون راوي الحديث الصحيح من الصحابة فمن بعدهم. That it has to be from the companion and anyone who's after him. Two narrators, if two people haven't narrated it from him, that's what it means, he said. Specifically from the companion. Anyways, the point is, Hafiz ibn Hajar, rahimahullah, corrects him on this as well. So whatever situation it may be, whether it be him saying that this the hadith which is Aziz is the only hadith Bukhari conditioned, then that's wrong. If he's talking about the companion specifically and anything that came after it, he's also here what? Muntaqad. He's also refuted in that. Another point that I need to mention and bring to your attention is, some of the innovators, people of innovation, like the Mu'tazila and other than them, they condition authenticity for it to have to be arba'atun an arba'atin. Four have to narrate from four. Mu'tazila, that's what they said. Ila muntaha al-isnadi, until the ending of the chain. So basically, it can't be mashhur, it can't be aziz, and it can't be gharib. They said that mashhur is three, aziz is two, and gharib is one. So it has to be onwards. And we did say that the mashhur is three and onwards, right? Three onwards. So for us, four is still mashhur. But they said that, pay attention to here, that the ahad that they only take is what? The mashhur. They don't take a hadith which is aziz, and they don't take a hadith which is gharib, the mu'tazila. In any matters related to the religion. لا فقه ولا في الفروع ولا في الأصول. They don't take it in فروع, which is فقيات, and they don't even take it in عقيده. Pay attention to that. Until the ending of the chain of narration. Okay? So this is powerful. And there's some of them within the Mu'tazila who said, we don't take a hadith which is ahad at all. لحتى مشهور we don't take. Not at all. The only hadith that we take is mutawatir. That's what they said. So we won't busy ourselves with those individuals, and we won't take time out to respond to them. We won't take time to respond to them. That is another time and another place to respond to them. So that's a stepping stone for somebody to reject the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. The Mu'tazila have put in place a stepping stone for the person who wants to reject the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, would use what? Would use the Mu'tazila as their argument. Are you there? Ahlul Bid'ah are like that. Generally, they're the ones who allow the enemies of Islam to wage war against Islam, right? Who allowed the Orientalists to say that the Quran is distorted? Who let them into the house? The Shia al-Rafidah did. They said the Quran is not preserved. Who allowed those who rejected hadith to exist? The Mu'tazila did. And the Shia and the Rafida did. Why? Because the Mu'tazila have said that the hadith are two types. There's a mutawatir and there's an ahad. And the hadith al-ahad is not taken. So then the munkiri as-sunnah, the one who's rejecting the sunnah, will say, let's take the bar a bit up. Let's add the mutawatir in there as well. What's the problem? Are you there? Whereas the person of the sunnah says, no, we take all the hadith. There's no entering point for you in any way, form or shape. We take a hadith. Fil furu'i wa fil usuli. Does that make sense? And innovators are always like that. That's why they're very dangerous. They show the enemies the entering point of Islam. And that's why the people of the sunnah are always harsh on them. They'll open the window. If you're fighting with an enemy and you're in your house and you lock your door and you lock everything and you sharpen your locks and you place extra locks on there, safe, strong, and then somebody opens the window for them and they come through the window, what would you see this person as? Great enemy. Great enemy. Why am I locking these doors? Why am I doing this? Why are you letting them in? This is Ahlul Bid'ah. So we Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, we believe Khabarul Ahad is taken. Who are from the people who reject Khabar al-Ahad today? Hizb al-Tahrir. Hizb al-Tahrir are Mu'tazila in their belief. Are you there? The Mu'tazila. They wouldn't accept Khabar al-Ahad, singular narration. They won't, right? They won't. Now, number four. وَالرَّابِعُ Hafiz al-Hajjah says number four. الْغَرِيبُ When he says four, what does he mean? مَا كَانَ مَحْصُورًا That which is restricted to an amount. But we would say it's the third type of ahad for us. Okay? What does this mean? غَرِيب is مَا كَانَ مَحْصُورًا بِرِوَايَةِ رَاوٍ وَاحِدٍ فَحَسْبٍ It's when one narrator is the one who narrated it. Only one narrator has narrated it. One person. This is called what? It is called Ghareeb. It's called Ghareeb. It's also called Fard. Sah? Both names are the same. You can call it a hadith which is Fard and a hadith which is Ghareeb. Both of them are the same. The author then says, وَكُلُّهَا سِوَى الْأَوَّلِ أَحَادٌ All of them are ahad except the first one. Except which one? Except mutawatir. Hafid goes back now and he says to you, other than the first one, is what? Ahad. So the other three that we mentioned, al-mashhuru, wal-azizu, wal-ghareebu, they all come under what? Ahad. They are all ahad. Here I want to bring to your attention something, brothers. These itlaqat that Hafiz ibn Hajar is using, what did he just do? He said, Al-Mashhur, Wal-Aziz, Wal-Gharibu are Ahad. It's unrestriction, right? He's itlaq unrestrictedly. And anything other than those three are what? Mutawatir, he said. Rahimahullah. This itlaq is when you say this hadith is Ahad like that, or you say Aziz like that, or you say Mashhur like that, and Ghareeb like that, this unrestricted of the word Ghareeb, Aziz, Mashhur, and you leave it like that, it's referring to fi jami'i tabaqati sanad. You're talking about through the course of every level of the narration. So if I say to you this hadith is Ghareeb, and I leave it there, it means it's Ghareeb from the time the companion narrated it from the Prophet until the ending of the chain. Are you there? That's what it means. If we say this hadith is mashhur, it means fi tabaqati sanad. If we say it's gharib, it means fi jami'i tabaqati sanad. If we say it's gharib, we mean fi jami'i tabaqati sanad. If we say this hadith is mutawatir, we mean it's what? Fi jami'i tabaqati sanad. We're saying it unrestrictedly. Does that make sense? So hafid here, he means that version. Are you with me? That's what he's talking about. But sometimes it could happen that we would say this hadith is mutawatir. Are you there? And we can say it's also gharib as well. Are you there, brothers? And this is from the ma yulghazu. Have you heard of lughz? Lughz is a riddle. Yeah? Sometimes there's riddles in hadith that people will ask you. They will say to you, سَمِّ لَنَا حَدِيثًا مُتَوَاتِرًا وَغْرِيبًا. Tell us a hadith which is mutawatir and it's ghareeb. You're like, what? That's an oxymoron. Ghareeb and mutawatir. That's like the two spectrums. Like ghareeb is what? Ghareeb is the lowest of mutahad. It's only one narrator. And then mutawatir is multitude narration. Like, I don't know how that works. How? Then the person should know what is meant by that. The example for that is the hadith of إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. Sahih? إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. And إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. Who narrated from the Prophet? Umar. Mutawatir from him. Alqamah ibn Abi Waqas al-Laythi. Mutawatir from him. From Alqamah, who narrated? Muhammad Ibrahim al-Taymi. That's mutawatir now. Then who narrated from Muhammad Ibrahim al-Taymi? Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari. This is where the hadith becomes from what? Anyone who narrated from Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari, it is mutawatir. I said 200 people narrated it, approximately. So the beginning of the hadith, or the beginning, like Umar radiallahu anhu, is the only one who narrated it from the Prophet. Or who narrated it to us from the Prophet. The only person who narrated it to us from the Prophet. Okay? Then we say he's the only person who heard it from the Prophet. Be careful. There could have been other companions who heard it from the Prophet. But we don't know. We don't have it. We have to specifically say the only person who narrated it to us from the Prophet. Are we all together? Umar did it. Because we know Umar, when did he narrate this hadith? Where did he narrate it? Umar was doing a khutbah when he narrated Innamal Amalu Binyad. Did the people in the khutbah not hear it? Did they not hear it? Yeah? They did. But the only person who narrated it to us from those people in the khutbah was who? Alqamah ibn Waqas al-Laythi. Hafiz ibn Hajar said there's a dispute whether he's a companion or not. There's a dispute. So if he's a companion, then we have two sahabis and two tabi'is. Are you there? We have two sahabas and two tabi'is. The two sahabas are Umar and Alqamah ibn Waqas al-Laythi. And Muhammad Ibrahim al-Taymi is a tabi'i, Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari is a tabi'i. So two tabi'is and two sahabas. That's if Alqama is a sahabi. If not, then it will be one companion, which is Umar, and three tabi'in. Are we all together? After Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari, the hadith became multitude. Adadun la yuhsa, a number that could not be what? Too much. It's mutawatir nisbi. It's what? Mutawatir nisbi. The mutawatir here is bin nisbati ila man? Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari. It's mutawatir through Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Ansari. It is gharib from before that. So that's the hadith you would use, for example, when somebody says to you, سَمِّ لَنَا حَدِيثًا غَرِيبًا وَمُتَوَاتِرًا. That's the hadith you give them. It's a riddle, because two of the descriptions are present in it. Does that make sense? So it can happen for every hadith, that sometimes the aziz is aziz nisbi to a particular narrator, he made it into two. Does that make sense? So that you have to remember, brothers. That's a side point, and it's a tanbih wallahi, which is muhim. Very important. Then the author, rahimahullah, said, وَفِيهَا الْمَقْبُولُ وَالْمَرْدُودُ. Oh. Now you have to understand. وَفِيهَا, in it. I want you guys to ask yourself, وَفِيهَا, in it. In what? In ahad. Only in ahad do we discuss the point called what? Maqbool and mardood. Accepting narration and rejecting narration. Do we do that in a hadith which is mutawatir? If a hadith has gained the conditions of tawatur, do we look at whether it's accepted or rejected? No. A hadith which is mutawatir, that is mutawatir, then it's what? It's what? It's maqbool. It's accepted. Are you there? Like in a hadith which is ahad, maqbool and mardood is present. Are we all together? Maqbool and mardood is there. So the qa'ida is, the principle that you have to remember is al-hadithu al-mutawatiru. The hadith which is mutawatir, fahuwa sahihun bila taraddudin. That's a qa'ida you need to memorize. Al-hadithu. Why don't I see you guys writing? Al-hadithu al-mutawatiru. The hadith which is mutawatir. فَهُوَ صَحِيحٌ. It is authentic, بِلَا تَرَدُّدٍ, without any what? Any hesitation. بِلَا تَرَدُّدٍ means no hesitation. It means, يعني, مَقْطُوعٌ بِصِحَتِهِ. We clearly cut its authenticity. And also, يُفِيدُ الْعِلْمُ الْيَقِينِ. If it's mutawatir, what does it bring us? It brings us certainty. ولذلك, question here, is mutawatir min mabahith ilm al mustalah? Question. Is, we're doing tahqiq here. This sharah Nukhbatul-Fikr is not just a go over now. We're going to tahqiq details. Is mutawatir, from the, does it fall under mustalah al-hadith? Should it be spoken about in mustalah al-hadith? Should it be discussed in mustalah al-hadith? Okay. Any other answers? They don't come together on a line. Okay. Hey?
You break it apart. You see, the part about what benefits you should be discussing is Rufa. That's not Al-Hawaii through Hadith. Generally, the concept of Mutawatir can be discussed in Hadith.
Remember when we took Uswar Arwaqat, what did we say? Khabar is what? ما يحتمل الصدق أو الكذبة لذاته. Remember, that's what they say. Yeah, that's what they say in ورقات. We discussed it, right? ما يحتمل الصدق أو الكذب. It's anything that can take a truth or it can take a lie, right? Remember we said that? Khabar is anything you can say, you're lying. Oh, you're telling the truth. And what did we say? Insha means ما لا يحتمل الصدق أو الكذب, صح? Is when somebody says, "Akhi, come here. May Allah forgive you. Can you say you're lying? Can you say you're lying? No, you can't. Somebody says, come here, Akhi. This is an insha, it's not a khabar. Because khabar is anything you can say, you're lying, you're telling the truth, right? Didn't we say that? So here the question is, doesn't mutawatir just seem like we have to verify if it's a lie or if this is true? But it doesn't have any place of maqbool and mardood. Because the whole backbone of mustalah hadith is what's authentic, what's not. What's accepted and what isn't. So some of the ulama al-muhaqqiqeen, they took the opinion that mutawatir is not min mabahith ulm mustalah. Shouldn't fall under the chapters of mustalah. Because what mustalah deals with is define ilm mustalah. Qawa'id yu'rafu biha, it's principles which you come to know, the hadith which are accepted and the hadith which are rejected. But mutawatir, we just said, we don't check if it's rejected or accepted. Sahih, brothers? All of the chapters of mustalah that is spoken about, if it hasn't got anything to do with whether it's accepted or rejected, it's not from the mabahith ilm mustalah. Are you there, brothers? It's not. So the truth of the matter is ilm mustalah really back, it really revolves back to khabar al-ahad. Fahasb. That's why if I was to draw the diagram for you guys right now, so we say, what did we say the khabar is? Sah? This was what? Bi'itibari? Usulihi ilayna, right? And then we said this is how many types? Al-mutawatir. And then tawatir we said is al-lafzi. And we said al- And then we said here is what? Al-Ahad, right? And then Al-Ahad, what did we divide it in? Yeah, Ahad, right? How much was the Ahad? Al-Mashhur, Al-Aziz, and Al-Gharib, right? These three, what do we look at from here? These three. What do we look at? These three is what we look at: al-maqbulu and al-mardud, right? Sahih, brothers. Are we all together? The maqbul and the mardud is specifically going to go to al-mashhur, al-aziz, and al-gharib, which is ahad, right? Are we all together? You're never going to hear about mutawatir anymore. It's gone. All you took was that mutawatir's definition, al-lafd and al-ma'nawi. Then this hasn't got anything to do with mubahid. It closes there. That's the last time you hear of it. All of that which we're going to take, whether it be what the hadith is, al-ta'anu fi al-rawi, you know, the hadith is weak, is mardood only for two reasons, right? A hadith is rejected only for two reasons. If your hadith is mardood, we reject this hadith, it's only one of two reasons. Al-ta'anu fi al-rawi or al-sakhtu fi al-sanad. The narrator is criticized or there's a disconnection in the chain. We're going to do that, don't worry, it's all going to come to us. Does that make sense? So all of that is just going to come from Ahad. The whole diagram is going to come out from Ahad. That's all Mustalah al-Hadith is now going to be. Are you with me, brothers? So this is what Mustalah al-Hadith deals with. Does that make sense? Anything from here onwards that the diagram comes out from is what? Is Ahad, and it is a mabhath min mabahith ilm al-Mustalah. As for mutawatir, عند التحقيق, when you look at it, it's from the mabahith of usul al-fiqh. Are we all together? It's from the chapters that deal with what? That you study in usul al-fiqh. Khabar, from that angle, is studied in usul al-fiqh. Are we all together, brothers? وَفِيهَا in the ahad is maqbulu, that which is accepted, and al-mardudu, that which is rejected. That is which is rejected. Are we all together? Now I want to mention a couple of points that are very important. Number one. These are very important points that I want you guys to take on board. Just because I said that the mutawatir is authentic without any hesitation, don't confuse it with kathratu turuq. You see a person, confuse the two. I said a hadith is sahih if it's mutawatir, true or false? And is there any doubt about that? There's no doubt about that. But kathratu turuq. The hadith has many narrations, many tariqah it came in, many turuq. Does that equal straight away sihah? Does that mean it? No. Reject that. Does that make sense, brothers? Why? Because kathratu turuq, the tariqah becoming more, was only one of the conditions of what? Mutawatir. Sahih. There were other conditions that we mentioned for mutawatir. Are you there, brothers and sisters? So some people, if they find a hadith has many tariqah, different 10, 20 tariqah, they'll say to you, it's mutawatir, equals mutawatir. And then once they say it's mutawatir, they will say to you, is what? It is sahihun. It's a hadith which is sahih, and there's no doubt about it, and there's no hesitation about it. Are you there, brothers? وَهَذَا خَطَأ. That's incorrect. That's not what we're saying. That's not what we're saying. Don't confuse mutawatir with many narrations. Why? Because mutawatir is more bigger than many narrations. Sahih. You remember the conditions that we mentioned for mutawatir? Kathratu turuq was only one of its four conditions. Sahih? Only one of its four conditions. The other three conditions are not there. So it doesn't necessarily mean that it's what? It doesn't necessarily mean that it's mutawatir. So you find a bahith, you're reading a kitab and you're reading it, and somebody says to you, this hadith is mutawatir. You research it. That's why you need to verify things. Especially rasail jami'iyya. These university degrees that people do, they love to do that. Once they feel like the hadith is so many different turuq, tariq, kada, kada, what will they do? They will strengthen it based on that. They will strengthen based on that, they'll say it's mutawatir. And that's ghayru sahih. One of the hadith that you can find that as an example is the hadith talab al-ilmi faridatun ala kulli muslimin. That seeking knowledge, this is an example. Seeking knowledge, okay, is obligatory on every male and female. طَلَبُ الْعِلْمِ فَرِيضَةٌ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ. This hadith, some of the mutaakhirin, the latecomers, those who came late, they ruled it by saying بِأَنَّهُ مُتَوَاتِرٌ. The hadith is mutawatir from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Based on what argument? Based on that 20 companions narrated it. They said 20 companions narrated this hadith. 20 Sahabiyyan approximately narrated this hadith. And we would say to them, okay, that's enough to say the hadith is mutawatir. That is, the number's large, no doubt. And the companions are here, no doubt. All of them, reliable, integrity, and everything, conditions are there. But the problem here is, when you research, you find that not one narration has correctly been attributed to that particular companion. Does that make sense? And in the tahqiq, sometimes people will say to you, this hadith has 20 or 40 turuq, but when you research, you find it goes back to only two tariqah, because it all goes back to one individual. It's made to look like it's a lot, but in the tahqiq, when you research, you actually realize that it comes back to two narrators. It comes back to two narrators. ولذلك that hadith, let alone it being mutawatir, some of the scholars have actually even graded it to be weak. Let alone it being mutawatir. They said it's not even sahih. It's weak. It's what? It's weak. And Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah, مثلا, he said, لا يثبت عندنا في هذا الباب شيء. This hadith is not authentic in this particular chapter. Or there's no authentic hadith in this particular chapter. I mean, there's nothing sahih. Ishaq ibn Rahawiyah, he said, أمراهويا, he said, لم يصح. It's not authentic. وَأَمَّا مَعْنَاهُ فَصَحِيحٌ فِي الْوُضُوءِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ إِنْ كَانَ لَهُ مَالٌ. Ishaq ibn Rahuya said this hadith is not authentically transmitted from the Prophet ﷺ. As for its meaning, what's the meaning of the hadith? That seeking knowledge is obligatory on every male and female. He said the meaning is correct. Especially when it comes to things that a person's ibadah cannot be done without it. Learning it, you have to. Fil wudu'i, such as wudu. You have to learn it. Everybody has to go and learn it. Was salati, and matters of salah. And al zakati. And zakat, in kana lahu malun, if he has wealth. ولذلك ابن عبد البر says in كتاب جامع بيان العلم وفضله يعني أنه يجب على المسلم أن يتعلم من أمور دينه ما لا تصح عبادته إلا به. That it's obligatory on the Muslim to learn matters of his religion ما لا تصح عبادته إلا به. عبادته إلا به. That which his religion will, or his ibadah won't be correct without knowing it, he has to learn it. He has to learn it. From the mutaakhirin, there are many who what? Who weakened it as well. From the mutaakhirin, there are many who weakened it. Some of them, they graded it to be hasan. And those who did it were mutasahilin, they didn't sahul. And there are even some of them who made it sahih and said it's sahih. Okay? And one of the person whose authentication is actually fascinating is Jalaluddin al-Suyuti. Al-Imam Jalaluddin al-Suyuti. Suyuti's authenticating of this hadith is amazing. Why? Because Suyuti said, وَلَمْ أُصَحِحْ حَدِيثًا لَمْ أُسْبَقْ لِتَصْحِيحِ سِوَهِ. I have never authenticated a hadith, no one preceded me in its authentication. Suyuti says that. That's what he says. And that's what he says after it. And it's fascinating the way he tries to authenticate it. Wallahu a'la wa a'lam. Allah knows best in this particular issue. We'll stop there inshaAllah ta'ala. There are many other issues that are very detailed, that need more explanation. But we'll stop there inshaAllah ta'ala. Anything which I've said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.